This video explains some of the basic functions in DDS-CAD. We will start with the mouse cursor. The left mouse button interacts with the program. The right mouse button opens the context menu of the activated function. By scrolling, you zoom in and out. Double-clicking the scroll wheel will reset the zoom to the complete model. Zoom out by clicking the scroll wheel or scrolling towards you. Double-clicking the scroll wheel resets the view to the complete model. When pressing and holding the scroll wheel, two functions can be used. Moving your mouse upwards will activate the pump function. Moving your mouse downwards will activate the zoom window function. Double-click the scroll wheel to view the complete model again. These are commonly used functions. Let us take a closer look into them. Use snap points highlights and locks the cursor when it's close to mid and intersection points. Use snap to grid. This function activates a grid to snap. To configure the grid, go to the menu format, grid coordinate options, and select the grid and snap properties. Use Smart Snaps activates the intelligent snap to systems and objects, such as a cable connection to a lamp. Use Surface Mode highlights and automatically selects surfaces. The Use Automatic Rotation function aligns an object automatically to a reference line when pressing Ctrl. The Use Ortho Mode function locks the line to certain angles. The Ortho Mode can be configured in a context menu using the different Ortho options. Helplines have many options available in the context menu. They can be used freely or from a specific reference line or point. To get a reference line, press and hold Ctrl and move the cursor to the line. Next, open the context menu. To use a reference point, press and hold Shift and move the cursor over the point. Next, open the context menu. When helplines are not required anymore, you can delete them. Objects can be selected by simply clicking the left mouse button. Make sure you click on the line of the object. You can also select objects using a selection window. A selection window from the lower left corner to the upper right corner selects the objects that are completely inside the window. A selection window from the lower right corner to the upper left corner deselects the objects that are completely inside the window. A selection window from the upper left corner to the lower right corner selects the objects that are inside and intersects the window. A selection window from the upper right corner to the lower left corner deselects the objects that are completely inside and intersecting the window. To select objects of the same type, select the desired object and open the context menu. Select the option Select objects of same type as the one selected. Making selection window once again will only select the windows in the model. You can easily move objects by clicking on one of the move nodes. Objects can also be moved by using a free reference point. This option is available in the context menu or by using the shortcut Shift-Ctrl-M. You can copy objects either via the context menu or Ctrl-C. They can be pasted by using the options in the context menu or Ctrl-V. The objects can be dynamically positioned, or they can be inserted on a certain distance from a copied object using the arrow keys. You can also copy objects by selecting free reference point. This function is available in the context menu or with the shortcut Shift-Ctrl-C. Objects can be rotated using the options in the context menu or with the shortcuts Shift-Ctrl-Left or right mouse button.